Thomas Tayebwa, the Deputy Speaker of Parliament, made the remarks while officiating at the launch of the Parliamentary Forum on Labour, Decent Employment and Productivity held at Imperial Hotel in Kampala. He tasked legislators on the forum that making a law to regulate labour externalisation should be their business number one.
We need a separate law on migrant labour. And I've seen, of course, we introduced a chapter in the Employment Bill, but that chapter was not satisfactory. We need a separate law on migrant labour. And the way I saw us struggling with the Employment Bill, I doubt it will come from government.
In May, Parliament passed the Employment Amendment Bill 2022. However, the House did not legislate a law specifically to streamline the rights of migrant workers. Now Tayebwa wants a law that will protect the remittances of migrant workers and also guarantee their safety at work.
It's a very critical resource that we have out there. But how are we helping them? What role are we playing as Parliament, as a government? Have we put in place a very critical and clear framework to support these people? Who is in charge? Is the regulator the one in charge?
Tayebwa also has put the government on alert to share with Parliament the basis of any tax revisions it will introduce for approval. He is concerned about the high tax charges on the public servants in Uganda compared to other countries in the East African region.
Government must share with us studies it has made that informs their decisions on tax revisions. If you are saying you're going to increase payee to 40% maximum, what informed that decision? If you are saying you're going to introduce this tax, what formed that decision? Can you share with us?
The chairperson of the forum, Roland Ndiomjenyi, says the body will provide a platform where strategic advocacy and pressure groups can analyze labor, employment, and productivity issues. It effectively undertakes legislation on issues relating to labor, employment, and productivity.
What we intend to achieve as members of parliament is to ensure safe and regular labor migration in order to contribute to the socio-economic transformation of our country.
Margaret Rabushaija, the forum chairperson, noted that the forum will build a sustainable world of work for workers to thrive and promote socio-economic transformation.